Hello, in this video I will try to explain Cuckoo Search Algorithm using an example. Before this I try to explain what is Cuckoo Search all about. That is explained in the Cuckoo Search part 1. So everything is explained step by step. In this video I will try to explain what is Cuckoo Search using example. Topics that are covered in this video: how we can calculate the values for Levy's flight, how we can calculate the value for Cuckoo's each step, and how we can update the Cuckoo's new position. Then we have certain question asked by user in Cuckoo Search part 1. Before starting this video, I want to mention one thing: whatever calculation done in this video, it's my own calculation, and if you found any error, please comment below. Simplicity of this algorithm is we use here only two parameters, that is the total population of the nest, and then we have the probability of discovery of cuckoo egg. For that value is 0.25, and these parameters are sufficient for maximum optimization problems. Third step is set the maximum number of iterations, that is here 300. And one thing is here, we cannot make any difference between cuckoo, egg and a nest. So the aim of this algorithm is we will replace the new and the better solution with bad solution that are in the current population. So it is important to remember that we cannot make any difference between egg, nest and cuckoo. So what is the aim of this algorithm? We are updating, or we will replace the bad solution with new and better one. So initialize the population of the host nest, that is 5. In the research paper, that is Cuckoo Search by Levy's flight, you can see here this is the final location of the nest, and you can see the search path of nest using y Cuckoo Search. So this example that is given in this video, I use the algorithm that is given in this research paper. You can see a number of research paper over the internet, and according to that there is a little bit difference in their algorithm. So this example is based on this algorithm. Initialize the population, we have only 5 host nest. You can see the position of each host nest here. You can see the initial population of host nest, that is 5, and the position of each host nest here. One thing I mentioned before, that we cannot make any difference between host nest, egg and a solution. So you can see here each position of the cuckoo, that is that we have only 5 cuckoo, and the position of each cuckoo here, and this is the optimal point, that is 100, and the position of cuckoo, you can see their position. So next step is, now we will obtain the new position for ith cuckoo. We will select a cuckoo randomly. For that we will obtain a new position using Levy's flight. Suppose in this, first of all I will choose first cuckoo, that is the value of I is 1 and the value of I is 1 to n. So I'm selecting here first cuckoo, this one, and we will perform Levy's flight using this equation. Here this is the current, this is a new solution, this is the current location, this is the step size, this is the entry-wise multiplication, and this is the Levy's exponent. So in order to calculate the Levy's flight, that is the random walk done by a word, that is cuckoo. Here cuckoo search algorithm is a random searching process. Here a word, that is cuckoo, searching for a suitable host nest for laying egg. So we will calculate Levy's flight using this, and random steps can be drawn from Levy's distribution. Levy's distribution means series of smaller steps, and we can express step size using this equation. Here one thing that is important: if the value you calculated for s is too small, that means the new solution generated will be far away from the older one. If the value of s is smaller, then it means change in position will be too small. So it is important to use proper step size for the search space. Put the values here. Here u is this v, you can see all the value. Value of beta is 3/2, and we got the value for standard deviation is 0.6966. Next, put the values here, and we got the step size is 0.33802. Here, s is the step size that determines how far a random walker can go for a fixed number of iteration. In general, random walk means it is a chain whose next location depends on the current location. Current location is the first term in the above equation that we will see in the example. You can see in the Levy slide we are using x best, that is the global best position. Right now this is the initial state, so we don't have any best position for any cuckoo or you can say host. So we will consider this value 0. Put the value of x best for this iteration 0. And we will calculate new solution using this. This is the old position plus Levy slide. Next, select a cuckoo randomly that I selected here. First cuckoo, position of first cuckoo is 4. Put the values here, set the counter 0, put the value of t0, you can see here. Now position of first cuckoo at iteration 0, that is 4, put the values here. Global best is 0. Right now we don't have any global best position for any cuckoo. This is the initial stage. So we got the new solution for the first cuckoo, that is 5.35. Next step is choose a nest randomly, then we will compare the value of cuckoo with the randomly selected nest. Here I selected a nest randomly, that is nest number 2, that is this one, and the value is here now 6. Now check this condition. Condition is false, it means cuckoo egg is not similar to host egg, so we will destroy the lowest rank egg and then we will generate a new egg near the older one. So the aim of this algorithm, again I'm repeating this point, replace the bad solution with the new and better one. This is the value that we calculated now for first cuckoo at first iteration. Keep the bad solution and we will increment the counter until we met the condition. Now we will select another cuckoo, that is cuckoo number 2, and the value for this cuckoo is 6. Put the value in the Levy slide and we got this one. Now we will select again any nest randomly. Put the value here, condition is true. It means that cuckoo egg is similar to host bird egg. Now we will replace the randomly selected nest with new solution and we will destroy the lower rank nest. Then we will calculate the value, that is the new solution for the cuckoo, for the second cuckoo, that is here. Update the position. Then we will select another cuckoo, that is cuckoo number 3. You can see here, this is the recently updated position for this cuckoo. Put the values here and in the Levy slide and we got the solution here. Again, check randomly, select any, you can select any nest randomly, then put the value here, check the condition. If it is true, then replace the solution by new solution and then calculate the new nest near the older one. Update it like that. We will update this for all, and this one is for the fifth cuckoo. Done. So these are the value we updated, and then according on the basis of these two we got this one. This is at iteration 1. Now we will increment the counter 1. You can see here, now we are here. Keep the best solution, that is here. Now we will rank the solution and we will find the current best. According to this you can see the current best is now this cuckoo number 5. This is the nearest one. So this is the current best. So for iteration 1, first value of counter is 0, that is the initial stage. Now value of counter is 1, so it is 2. And now we have global best position, that is cuckoo number, here you can see 5. This is the global best position. Now in the next iteration, put the value of global best 28.844, and you can see when you will try to calculate this, now the value of counter is 2. So this is the new solution we are calculating for the first cuckoo. Here we will put the value, position of first cuckoo at iteration 1 that we recently calculated, 7.16. put the value here and global best is here 28.884. we are updating the bad solution with the new and the better one. So we have now random questions that are asked in the part 1. So first question is, In Cuckoo search, is each egg is equivalent to a nest, and thus the solution is a nest too. Yeah, this is in this algorithm they assumed that the cuckoo, egg and host, they are similar. We cannot make any difference between any cuckoo, egg and host nest. So all of them are point in the space that are changing their position. Done. Second question is how we can calculate Levy's distribution. Levy's distribution means series of smaller steps that you can see in this slide, how we are calculating these smaller steps using Levy's flight. Done. Next question is, does entry wise multiplication means element by element entry multiplication? Yes, this in this example they are using vector form. So in the Cuckoo search we are doing entry wise multiplication, and you can see here that we have different parameters that are used for maximum optimization problem, and these parameters are sufficient. I provided all the important link in the description box. And still, if you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.